What's up, everybody? Once again, it's Brand Man Sean, and we got to talk about what you should do if you get scammed by a bigger artist. Now, what am I talking about exactly? Well, picture a situation where you pay an artist for a feature. After you pay that artist for a feature, they do the song, you get a verse. Either it's a pre-recorded verse that, you know, you lay over a track, or you guys recorded, you know, together on the same track, whatever it is, it happened. However, after you record that song, after the song is finished, you like, yo, I'm about to blow up. I'm about to get all this traction. This artist is already moving. People are gonna love that I got this bigger artist that's taking off on my music. There's a problem here. A lot of artists are running into situations where the other artist, the bigger artist, is not abiding by whatever the agreement was. Whether that's showing up for the music video, whether that's promoting the song on their Instagram page or their Twitter account and all these other forms of promotion they might have access to. For whatever reason, these artists are not holding up to the agreement. One big reason is something that you can control, kinda, not sorta. And then we're gonna get into two ways you can solve this for yourself if you already got the music. All right, so first of all, one big thing, the reason this happening is a lot of these artists are hating. And what are they hating? They're hating when the smaller artists who are supposed to be nothing perform better than them on these songs. That's one thing that has actually happened multiple times that I've heard of, just running into people randomly, and they mentioned that this has happened. And it's not like, oh, the artist thinks, yo, I perform better than that bigger artist, they hating on me. It's something that they've actually learned through real information that's how people feel, and that artist is aware of that feeling as well. Now they're in their feelings. It sucks, but I get it. I guess, you know, one of the 48 laws of powers is never outshine the master. In this case, the artist that's bigger is kind of the master. And I'm not saying that you shouldn't perform well, right? You would want to kill a track that you have a big feature on, because in most cases, that track will probably get more attention than your other track. So why would you not make sure that you're at your best? Once again, I get it, it sucks. Whatever. I'm not gonna get into the nuances of some of the smaller things that might happen, but two ways that you can solve this for yourself is this. Numero uno, you can create a cartoon visual type video of you and that other artist. Huh, they didn't show up for the video, cool. You'll just make a video that they don't need to be in because you know you got some heat, and even though there might be some things as far as you need to figure out how to get the money, or you might want to sue them at some point, all in all, you might just have to do what you have to do. So creating a cartoon visual animated video or something like that integrates their presence without them actually having to be there could work for you. And then the second thing, just a single. You don't necessarily even have to have a music video in this case, but the track is done. They haven't promoted it. You already dropped it. You're slowly losing traction on this new track that you thought was gonna blow up because they were supposed to post it, you know, a week or 2 weeks after you dropped it yourself. Well, one thing you can do is go to that artist's followers. Right? That artist has followers on Instagram, and just start dropping it into people's DMs. Like telling them, yo, here's a song I did with such and such. And you can even make it seem like it might be a song by that person and let them hear it that way. It might be a super manual process. It might be annoying that you have to go this route as opposed to the person just promoting it themselves. But honestly, in my opinion, I'm not opposed to, even if they did post it, you doing this anyway, because it's just doubling down on getting their fans' attention that this track exists. It just makes it better that the person supported it and posted it on their page. Anyway, those are just two ways to handle a kind of, you know, iffy situation if you really, really feel like your back is against the wall. There's a lot of nuances that could be in other people's individual situation that I'm not gonna get into, but it's definitely something to think about. We'd love to know you guys' thoughts. Have you ever been scammed by a bigger artist? How did that happen? How did you handle it? Other than that, if you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button. If you like it, might as well share it. And if you're not subscribed, you know what to do. Hit that subscribe button.